It's a tank redesigned from the ground up with lessons from the Ukraine war in mind. In many ways, it makes it a tank of the future, including artificial intelligence, enhanced sensors, and the ability to defeat the same Javelin and NLAW missiles that have been savaging Russia's tank fleet. It's the AbramsX, a huge evolutionary leap forward from the venerable stalwart tank design of the US Army. But it might be so revolutionary that the Army won't buy it. In 1979, the first M1 Abrams was revealed to great fanfare. It was replacing the M60, a Cold War stalwart, and meant to go toe-to-toe with the Soviet tanks, who were slowly but surely gaining the upper hand. Its designers were confident the Abrams could defeat the best the Soviets could throw at it, but nobody was sure this risky redesign of traditional American tanks would really be up to the task. Then, in 1991, the Abrams got to show the world just how it would have handled itself in a winner-take-all battle for Europe. Taking on hordes of Soviet-built main battle tanks in the hands of veteran Iraqi crews, the Abrams absolutely eviscerated the competition, with the only losses being due to friendly fire. It was clear that the United States had won the tank competition. But that was 30 years ago, and now the US faces new threats. And that's why General Dynamics believes that it's time for a drastic redesign of this American classic. But the US Army isn't convinced. Current Abrams feature a 120mm main gun that can fire data-linked ammunition, depleted uranium armor in combination with highly classified British Chobham armor, thermal sights, a fire computer to help the crew hit targets even at full speed on bumpy terrain, a networked capability to help it communicate with other friendly assets, and finally the Trophy Active Protection System to allow it to defeat enemy anti-tank missiles. The Abrams X builds on these strengths and then enhances them. First, it's the new gun. While it's still a 120mm cannon, the new gun spotted on a General Dynamics technology demonstrator is the XM360, a cannon originally developed in the early 2000s for the Army's future combat systems. This program was meant to catapult the US Army into a new era of technological domination. But after $18 billion spent on the program, it failed to produce a single working combat vehicle. However, while the FCS was an abject failure as a whole, it produced a great deal of successes and taught the Army many lessons. The XM360 cannon is one of those breakthroughs. While it and the current M256 cannon both share the same ammunition and have roughly the same firing characteristics, the XM360 is much lighter thanks to the use of titanium and composites. That might not seem like a big upgrade, but when you're talking about a gas-guzzling, fuel-hungry vehicle that weighs over 60 tons, every single pound shed means enhanced mobility, endurance, and speed. You're going to hear this a lot in this episode, because the Abrams X is so new and top secret, details are extremely scarce. But other performance upgrades that this new cannon uses are unsurprisingly classified. However, we expect this new cannon will provide the ability to use all sorts of new data-linked ammo types, though an Abrams won't be shooting an anti-tank missile out of its barrel anytime soon like some Russian designs. When your cannon is as lethal as an Abrams, you don't need fancy missiles to wreck targets. Weight is a big deal with modern main battle tanks, and the M1 Abrams has been putting on weight like a pro heavyweight fighter in intense training. When it first came out of development, the Abrams weighed a bulky 60 tons. However, after a slew of upgrades including new engines, depleted uranium armor, and enhanced survivability packages for urban combat, the Abrams was starting to look like it had been going too hard on its heavyweight diet. Clocking in at 73.6 tons, the Army had serious concerns about how current Abrams would fare in combat today. Bridge crossings are especially concerning, as this much weight puts the Abrams out of safety limits for many civilian bridge infrastructures. It's increasingly looking like current Abrams should learn how to swim, or will have to rely on engineers to build them bridges. A dicey proposition. Just ask the Russians in Ukraine. The Abrams X is purported to have dramatically cut the weight of this mighty war machine, though how and where remains classified. Returning to its roots, the Abrams X is back at its fighting weight of 60 tons, without losing any of its current capabilities. Reduced weight in the cannon and the use of composites elsewhere is largely to thank for this engineering feat, but other weight-cutting measures remain to be disclosed, and probably never will be. Reduced crew might be a reason for lower weight, as the Abrams X features the first American three-crew design. The Soviets initially designed autoloaders for their tanks at the start of the Cold War, and this promised to relieve the logistical burden of an extra crew member. However, American observers noticed that the autoloaders experienced frequent breakdowns and other technical problems, thus giving America a serious distaste for them. Despite the fact that many modern tanks such as the Leopard 2, Japanese Type 10, and South Korean K2 all feature autoloaders, the US Army isn't convinced that this is the right call. They prefer good old human autoloaders who cannot jam or experience any other mechanical or electrical malfunction. Plus, human autoloaders tend to provide for a higher rate of fire, though after loading a dozen or more heavy tank shells, the human is going to eventually get worn out. There is practical reasons for the Abrams to retain a fourth crew member, though. In case of a track being thrown, the crew has to get out and perform a fix themselves. With tracks weighing hundreds of pounds, that extra pair of hands is a huge help. This also applies to regular maintenance, which a fourth person really helps with. In case the tank breaks down in hostile territory, a fourth crew member can help provide added security to the stricken tank. But the Abrams X is going European with the introduction of an auto loader. It promises to provide the same rate of fire as a human loader with increased reliability. It also has one other huge benefit. The crew has been removed from the turret and placed inside the hull itself. This is a dramatic improvement for crew survivability, as the armor in the hull is thicker and more difficult to penetrate, while in current designs, part of the crew is in the turret itself. This new Abrams features three crew hatches at the front of the tank, allowing the entire crew to exit in case of emergency and removing a fundamental weak point of current Abrams design, as the hatch is a significant weak spot in the already weaker top armor. The US Army remains skeptical, however. The turret does feature one significant upgrade over the Abrams, though, and that's the inclusion of a 30mm chain gun to replace the traditional 50 caliber machine gun operated by the commander, and the loader's M247.62mm machine gun. Here, too, the Army is split, as this is both an upgrade and a downgrade. Built with lessons from Ukraine in mind, the XM914 30mm chain gun fires at blistering speeds and is designed to take on everything from lightly armored vehicles like the Russian BMP-3 to drones and other low-flying vehicles. This allows the tank to save its main gun ammo for thicker skin targets like enemy tanks. But it also means that there's one less machine gun protecting the tank from enemy infantry. If the Abrams X does ever make it into production, don't be surprised if the Army demands the 7.62mm machine gun be put back on the vehicle. A serious upgrade, though, that the Army can't complain about is the remote control technology that allows the 30mm chain gun to be controlled from the safety of the tank's interior. Current machine guns on the Abrams require an operator to have half their body hanging out of the tank, an obvious risk in a hectic battlefield. From the safety of the tank's thick armored hull, though, the crew can use a variety of vision modes, including thermal, to fire the chain gun and obliterate enemy targets. Perhaps the biggest visible change that the Abrams X brings to the table, and one the Army is enticed by, is the new hybrid electric diesel engine. Currently, Abrams use a gasoline engine, and it's an absolute gas-guzzling monster, consuming at just over 1 gallon per mile traveled. The range of an M1 today is around 275 miles, meaning that America's tanks have to be closely followed by logistical support, which makes for a very tempting target. However, the Abrams X promises a 50% enhanced fuel efficiency, and the switch to diesel is seriously attractive to the Army given that the rest of its vehicle fleet also relies on diesel. This would significantly reduce logistical strain and costs, as the entire Army fleet could just share one fuel type. The new engine also comes with new battery packs that will hold a classified level of charge. General Dynamics has promised that the Abrams X will be able to operate in silent battery-powered mode while stationary. This will allow the tank to run on its full suite of sensors and sights without cranking up the engine, thus presenting an even more obvious target to the enemy's heat-seeking missiles and drones. However, a big change is hinted at the possibility that the Abrams X will have some limited mobility while in battery mode. This means that the biggest, baddest tank in the world could transform into a ninja for short amounts of time. Other than the armor, few things about the Abrams X are as classified as its new artificial intelligence technologies. General Dynamics has not released many details, but says that the tank's AI suite will be able to assist crews by identifying targets for them amidst the chaos of a battlefield. Using advanced algorithms, the tank will be able to detect enemy vehicles and classify them as threats or non-threats, even the type of vehicle despite rain, snow, smoke, or thick fog. It'll then suggest ammo types and a firing solution for the commander, though it'll be the commander who makes the final call. Despite fears, the Abrams X is not going to take over the world if its AI goes rogue. At least for now. As seen in the war in Ukraine, modern tanks are incredibly vulnerable to both drones and advanced anti-tank missiles, such as the Javelin and the NLAW. That's why the Abrams X is built from the ground up with this threat in mind. Many have observed the truly apocalyptic scale of losses amongst Russian armored forces and wondered if there was any future for tanks anymore. However, the Abrams X active protection system will allow it to blast incoming rockets and missiles, allegedly providing the tank protection even from weapons like America's own Javelin, which has mauled Russian tanks. And if the tank does take a significant hit, American tank crews won't have to worry about competing with their Russian counterparts in the turret-tossing Olympics. Russia will retain the gold medal in turret-tossing for the foreseeable future, with their tanks achieving some truly Skyrim space program-worthy heights. The reason so many Russian tanks are built as both tank and aircraft is because the Russians decided to have the tank's ammunition ring the entire turret. Thus, when the tank takes an even moderate hit to the turret, all of the ammo goes off and sends the turret into orbit while incinerating the crew. America likes its soldiers to be soldiers and not astronauts, so Abrams tanks have always kept the ammo in a separate compartment with the inclusion of blowout panels. The AbramsX has been spotted with what appears to be a blowout panel atop the turret, continuing the proud Western tradition of not having your tank send your entire crew into space from one RPG hit to the turret. Details might be scarce, but the AbramsX already looks to be a significant starting place for a big leap forward in American tank design. However, it faces significant challenges even just getting funded, as the Army is already displeased with some of its basic design elements, like the loss of a fourth crew member. However, the biggest barrier standing in the AbramsX's way is the fact that the United States military does not currently face a serious land threat. Instead, it looks like its next war will be against China, and a Sino-American war will take place at sea and in the air. U.S. tank crews are extremely unlikely to see any action in such a war, and thus funding priorities for a new battle tank remain incredibly low. Now go check out Hitler's insane 1,000-ton war machine, or click this other video instead.